So it is currently 2:45 in the morning.
Yeah.
And we're waiting for our flight to, where are we going?
To San Salvador. And then Honduras.
And, yay. Yep. And I haven't slept in 22 hours.
So. Hello. That's me, Carly. I'm annoying, I know, but I like to tell stories, and you should listen to this one, because it's good. Last year, after going on a medical service trip to Panama, three of my friends and I decided to start a club. Mostly because we were all power hungry, but also because we were science majors with passions for people and interests in healthcare. So we started this club called Public Health Brigades, which is actually a subchapter of a much larger international organization called Global Brigades. Focused on holistic education and sustainability, Global Brigades was founded in 2004 by college students just like us. And now the organization has 9 subchapters in 4 countries, ranging from architecture to human rights to microfinance, all focused on empowering impoverished communities to improve equality of life. That's pretty cool, right? We thought so. So, this past March, after almost 9 months of preparation, our little group of 19 students got on a plane to Honduras to visit the community of El Ojal.
You know, this is the world's most dangerous airport.
I've heard. Read a Yahoo article about it.
Yeah.
That's how you know it's true.
Right.
In El Ojal, we were split into 2 groups to work with 2 different families. Both families' homes needed a little help, so we were to build a hygiene station consisting of a shower, a sink, and a latrine, a clean burning stove, and cement floors. Of course, we had the help of local carpenters, or should I say that we were the help for local carpenters, because Lord knows that none of us knew how to build anything. Mostly, we were just the manpower for the people who actually knew what they were doing. There's a lot of heavy lifting, carrying rocks, and mixing cement. A lot of mixing cement. After the home infrastructure projects were built, we had a full day to work with the entire community at their local school. All the kids packed into one room while we gave a small presentation about public health. The kids were pretty good sports and even put up with our terrible song about water that made absolutely no sense. And then one of our families made us food. Like, real Honduran fried fish and plantains and vegetables, delicious, amazing food. Now, I'm a vegetarian, by the way, but I still ate that fish. Nom 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 nom.
Hi, my name is Dennis.
My name is Daniela.
Hey, mi nombre es Julia Cruz.
Woo! Hello.
I'm Aaron.
Isabel.
Allison.
Well, I empecé el 2006 trabajando en brigadas médicas, también en brigadas de agua. Actualmente pues trabajo hace 5 años en el programa de salud pública solamente.
Soy miembro de la Junta de Agua, estoy ahí como vocal 1 y apoyo en lo que ha sido toda la trayectoria del proyecto.
Pues a través del tiempo, la experiencia, pues hemos, junto con todo el staff de Global Brigade en Honduras, también el mundo, los que están en Estados Unidos, pues la idea es formar líderes comunitarios en las comunidades para que pueda ser autosostenible.
El comité lo conformamos 8 miembros. Hay una coordinadora y un subcoordinador, los cuales nos encargamos de vigilar porque la comunidad esté limpia. Y hoy que ya tenemos el agua, a vigilar también para que los proyectos de salud estén funcionando como debe ser.
You know, this kind of like preventative medicine, I feel like it's a lot better in the long run.
Nosotros como comité también damos charlas educativas tanto a los niños en la escuela como adultos también. Cuando tenemos reuniones, ahí aprovechamos para darles charlas educativas. El cómo la importancia de tener limpia la comunidad, la importancia de que los niños se eduquen en su aseo personal.
You definitely connect more with families. It's hard to connect with 500 people that you meet in one day because it's impossible to. Where public health brigade, you stay with the family for a week and you really get to know them and bond with them, and it's actually kind of sad that we're gonna leave them soon.
A través del tiempo, pues mi vida ha ido cambiando de una forma muy abierta, muy apasionado. Apasionado también por mi trabajo que hago y también la motivación pues que tenemos a través de los estudiantes, verdad, que vienen de diferentes partes del mundo, que en las comunidades nosotros somos el enlace, verdad, para que todo el trabajo se pueda llevar de la mejor manera junto con los estudiantes y igualmente la comunidad. Y para mí es algo muy importante en mi vida y también ha cambiado mi vida.
So, you know, back in the States, I tell my friends and my family like what we're gonna do, building a hygiene station with a toilet and a shower and an eco stove, and they're like, oh yeah, you know, that's cool, I guess. Because to them that's all we're doing. But really, this experience is so much more because you're empowering the community, you're giving them hope in their future and enabling them to go on and do more with what they have.
Antes de entrar Brigada Global en esta comunidad de Los Ochar, apenas 3 viviendas tenían su servicio sanitario. La mayoría de 54 viviendas que son las que componen el Los Ochar no tenían, que no tenemos palabras para decir gracias no es suficiente para todo lo que hemos logrado, todo lo que tenemos ahorita y pensar lo que no teníamos antes de Brigada Global.
The biggest impact that this trip made on me personally was realizing the difference between a statistic and a real person. Because you can see statistics on, you know, public health and poverty and all these things, but when you're seeing who these people are up close, it makes a very profound difference in how you view these issues and how you view, you know, your own personal impact, what that could be. Because we made a big personal impact on, you know, maybe not a huge number of people, but the statistic isn't what's important there.